So my name is Xiaokun Shu. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry. I started from studying physics. That's about my bachelor degree. And then I continued my graduate study at University of Oregon. I studied biophysics there. And then after I finished my PhD, I moved to San Diego in 2007. And there I learned how to design and develop genetic tools for biology. And now I'm here at UCSF, which is very famous for its biological study. And we have very good tradition about extensive collaboration among faculty. So this is the ideal place for me, because now I'm trying to move from genetic tool development to biology studies. Right now, in my own lab at UCSF, we are developing infrared fluorescent proteins, because if we want to know how disease develops, like how cancer develops, we need to study those proteins in animals, not just in culture cells. So for that, visible light is not very efficient for this study, because visible light is absorbed by hemoglobin. That's why the blood looks red, because hemoglobin in the blood, they absorb visible light, so it looks like red. So for this infrared fluorescent proteins, here I'm trying to improve its brightness. Infrared light can penetrate through tissue much better than visible light. So here, for example, if we want to study P53 protein, which is involved in many cancer development, we can just attach our infrared fluorescent protein to P53, and then we can study the expression and localization of this P53 protein in mice before the mice develop cancer. We will know what's going on there at the molecular level before any big tumors form. After we figure out the molecular mechanisms of this cancer development, for example, caused by this abnormal expression or activation of this P53 protein, then we can use this knowledge to understand cancer development in humans, and we can also develop therapeutic drugs against this abnormal properties of P53, and then we can figure out how to fight against those cancers.